coastal bays and lakes are challenged now by chemical runoff, debris, trash, all kinds of invasive plants and algae that is creating detrimental lake health. This is one of the biggest challenges right now to water bodies across the United States. Well, one of the things that's incredible about invasive plants and algae that are introduced to this area is they're very successful. They're able to come into an environment from another part of the world, Southeast Asia, Africa. They come over here and they find the temperament, the water climate to be perfect for growing. So they outcompete the natural vegetation. What this ends up happening is the fish that are normally able to grow and proliferate are reduced, and in its place are these algal species and invasive weeds that end up completely taking over a lake or a coastal bay. In the New England area in particular right now, there's a big influx of hydrilla that's coming in. It used to be confined to the south, but now it's moving northward. And they're just finding it in the last 2 years, overtaking a lot of lakes and ponds and freshwater areas. Texas and the Gulf region represents some new challenges, particularly with a plant called Savinia. Savinia is a floating emergent plant that is taking over the surface of a lot of the water there. So in particular, this round plant with little small nodules on it is taking over primarily the freshwater systems around Texas. This is going to cause a lot of issues this coming warm season with the ability for boats to maneuver and for the big fishing industry that we have throughout Texas. It's moving into the other areas of the Gulf, and it's been in Florida for quite a while, but to see it move to the other side of the Gulf now is alarming. Florida is the big test bed. Just about everything you can imagine is going to hit Florida first. Right now, one of the problems that's happened since 1996 is a common aquarium plant called Rotella. And Rotella, as beautiful as it is, can grow 7-8 feet, and it is pervasive in the canal systems down here in Florida. So it's going to make stormwater protection, the stormwater flooding, to become even a larger problem than it already is. For some time now, there's been a plant called Sargassum that is a macroalgae. It's not an invasive aquatic plant. It has no vascular system, but it has little bladders, and it's able to float. And as it's floating, it's been able to coalesce and create islands. Some of these islands are 35 miles long. And so what they do is not only are they collecting other algal species that are floating in the water, but they're picking up debris, trash, plastic bottles. And this creates an incredible problem for sea life. Turtles will see a plastic bag and think it's a jellyfish. It kills a turtle. Seabirds will try to come down and find fish and end up getting tangled in the Sargassum. One of the great things about mechanical harvesting, and what I'm really excited about, is that mechanical harvesting is precise. If you have a habitat that you're trying to preserve for ducks, waterfowl, you can go in with mechanical harvesting and go after only the area where the aquatic vegetation or the algae is overgrowing a particular area. So it's very precise. It can go in, clean up that one area, and leave valuable habitat alone. Now, herbicides, pesticides have their place in lake management, but what we think we can do with harvesting is minimize the amount or degree of herbicides that are needed in order to maintain a good, healthy lake system. So we can work in conjunction with herbicides or eliminate, in some cases, completely eliminate the need to have an herbicide used if we can do regular, consistent harvesting over a warm season. One of the things I'm really excited about Weedoo, unlike some of the other sea harvesters that have been out there in the past, is that we're able to work with less people. One person can operate the machine. We can go in and precisely take in one area of vegetation and remove it. It uses a minimal amount of any type of fuel. In fact, one of our models works completely on solar. So it's more agile, it takes less manpower, it's more ecological, and the other thing that's important is the way the machine is designed, the bycatch, the critters, the invertebrates, the larvae of fish, can sift through the machine and go back into the water. Most harvesters can't do that.